So this is another of my camera crawler videos, and if you find this enjoyable, please click like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Do check out the playlist, because that's how I organize the videos on different subjects. So in the previous video, we put the drive shafts and the axles together, and in this video, we're going to start to assemble the cage. And it looks like, until the last second, this thing doesn't really function as a vehicle. So, here we go. Shame, because it's really a brilliant design, but it's very dependent on the roll cage. So I'm going to gently move this over so it doesn't fly apart. And actually, we can kind of, it can crawl up there. And I've got the parts kind of scattered all over the place because I haven't quite figured out how this works. And I, you know, in case you are just joining this project, I will not be building this as an actual Capra car. I'm going to make a detour at some point. Eek. That's a lot of screws. So, all right, I think we need in this bag. Yeah. So I'm not going to put the little guys in my car, because I don't care about that. That's not relevant to me. Yeah, I really don't care about the little guys. I may end up using this piece, but not right now. And then we've got some more little frame pieces and the little radio box piece, which we will be using this. So let's see if we can make heads or tails out of what's going on here. Well, it looks like we're going to get into this pretty quick. We'll just go ahead and dump everything out in one pile. That way we can sift through it. Alright, so here's the little helmet guys that, again, I'm not putting little people in my car. Oh, that's interesting. There's machining marks on the bottom of their mold. And the serial numbers on the radio box. That's kind of sad, but whatever. And then they did give us a little LED bar. That's cool. We will use this. Because, yeah, it represents lights. And we'll be adding more of this to the car. Because, yeah, that's headed in the direction we are. So, now what I got to do is uncover enough of this to figure out how this actually goes together. So, I need this piece. Goes like that. And then I need that and that. And apparently these go like this. And they go out. So that means this one goes here. This one goes here. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Sort of a little moon buggy-ish. And then we need A1118s, which are 3x18s. So we'll just set that there. So we need two of these. Looks like we have plenty. Just slip this in here. Oh, are you kidding me? Yeah, same thing we've had with other parts in this kit. They didn't flare the end, so I'm using a 2.5mm to just dig in there a couple millimeters and make it where I can get the threads in. And that little itty-bitty push like that makes it that much easier to get this started. And then I'm going to leave that a little bit shy of done because I want to get the assembly together before I tighten that. Okay, so that kind of brings that there. And then we need the box. And the wires go towards this, and the box sits in here like this. So we use little, let's see, AX115s, which are 3x10. So 3x10. That looks a 3x10. It seems suspiciously easy. And it doesn't say anything about what goes through the outside, so so I'm very clear that this goes here. Okay, that's how that works. So it goes in from the bottom. And that lines that up. All right. And again, I'm not going to tighten everything down until I get all the pieces together. Goes in there, and that goes in there. It doesn't say anything about screws, so now we're going to go ahead and tighten this down now that we've got that connection kind of mated. Alright, so that's looking good. Pieces. 3,999,000 left. So we want this piece with the other side. So, it looks like these go like this. No, that doesn't make any sense. Go out like this. If that's the case, so, that goes out, and this this doesn't make any sense. Okay. So I gotta figure out how this fits together, and I'm not seeing it right now. Let's just humor this and try the other side. I don't even see it. That starts to feel like it could fit. Especially if we bring that in. But that doesn't feel right. I don't see that. So this calls for long. It suggests that it goes there. Well, that sure doesn't look right, but we'll screw it in temporarily and see if we can figure it out. No, there's no way. Well, this start... I thought maybe I had a 2mm driver, and I don't. So I guess I'm stuck doing this by hand, which is probably the better way to do it anyway. Okay. All right, there we go. Okay, so now we've got a little cross brace piece somewhere around here. Yep. The front. And the front goes in to here and here. Not a big deal. It's a 1/1/8, which is my nemesis. Just say it's go forever. Literally a half an inch of thread. So it's getting quite stiff. There's another connector back here that'll get made. It probably involves this. I'm certain it involves that. Cute little lights. I don't think they really do anything in this case. Okay, that goes to the front. That goes to the back. More, you guessed it, 118s. There we go. Now we've got something up here. I'm not quite sure where this goes, but I think that's it right there. Yep. There's a top and a bottom to this. The screw faces up, or the center screw faces up. So it's 116. Okay. Oh, that sucks. These stupid things are supposed to go on here. Looks like they still can. These are the hinges for the little hood thing. So this just needs to be snapped out. There we go. I think this is a wire guard or a wire clip that's going in. So that was what I was installing right there. Okay, so next we get to put all this together. Gosh, this would be a lot easier if I had a screw gun for this. We're gonna do this a little different. Nice way to do this. Thank you. it's just hurting my arms, so I gotta pause. I'll be back in a minute. There we go. That's one of like 12. Two of 12. So these snap together, kind of, there it goes. Okay, so that's good. 116. Let's go ahead and get that out of the way because that's small. Okay. Now in the back, we've still got a bunch of these to do. So we'll go ahead and put this long one in right there. It's just a little not quite aligned, and that's easy to bend it in place and get it started, and then it'll be fine. Screw check. So next we need to go up here, and we've got one there and there. Six, so let's get that out of the way. We're getting there. So we're doing this side up here. Alright, got one more to do up here. So we're just pulling this gap closed here. And we're good. Alright, time for a better change. Alright. So let's turn the page and see what is next. So it calls for the radio and the, yeah, we're not doing that. Okay, so these are going to get recycled. I'm not putting the little guys in. Let's see, how stupid does this look? Yep, I don't need this. And quite frankly, this should have been gone. This should have gone in before. Put it in here to see what it looks like. Yeah, it looks like what I think it looks like. It makes it a toy, even though it's Lexan and it's pretty durable stuff. Yeah, we're gonna pop this out of here. And we're gonna recycle it. Bye-bye. Alright, the little headlight thingies we will put on here because they actually hold something down. Okay, so .229. Really? These are just really long screws. That's what the noise is about. They're 18 millimeters. And they use the 1.5 millimeter driver. Two. so that one's pretty much lined up. That's why it wouldn't fit. It's the wrong size. I'll deal with that in a minute. I'm gonna finish putting this one in. Alright, what is going on here? I'm sorry, I'm doing this in my lap, which isn't helping you guys, but I needed to turn it so I could kind of see down on a crack to get it aligned. Alright, so that's good. Let's see. This is cute. It goes in here. All right. And let's see what size. 235098. They're M2.5 by 8 millimeters. So these are tiny. Well, that isn't it. Alright, we'll go ahead and put the lid on because we can't quite figure out what this does. Those are M2.5 by 12. That's those guys. Alright, I'm just starting. I'm not going to finish them because... Alright, we got to figure out what this does and how it fits in here. I think this goes in here like this. As part of like some kind of dashboard thing. If that's the case, it may just go away. Because I don't need a dashboard. Alright, now for the fun part that we've all been waiting for, where we get to pull this back over. Everything with A118 volts. So these go up. So, what we gotta do here is get to the bottom of this, and this is probably gonna get messy. Here's one. Here's two. So let's make sure we've got this clearanced. Yep, alright, that's clearanced. Click that out of the way. And then we'll go screw for life. Something to do this with automation. So I'm going to go ahead and bolt the shocks in so that I can start to kind of hold this thing still. And I'm not done with the ones in the back by any means. This is just to sort of stabilize the frame so that the drive shafts won't fall out and cause me to say bad words on camera. Now, those of you who've watched me for a while know that, yeah, I don't really care about saying bad words on camera. Now, you may want more height in your ride. I don't. So I've got soft suspension settings, and I'm putting the shocks in the lowest position they go in. All right, now I can focus on. Actually starting to look like a car now. Probably got a screw missing one of these. I'll dig around for it. But I want to get these started so that I can then deal with. I'm going to move the instructions out of the way because I really do need to be able to turn this to work on it. And I'm just kind of looking around for the screw that I can't find that I need. Two more on this side, and I'm still missing a screw. Okay. So now I'm just looking for one lousy screw. That's not the right size, but it is the right diameter. I guess that's going to work. There it is. Let's see what the instructions say we need to do now. Body parts and wheels. Okay. So I'm not putting body parts on at this moment. Possibly later. So I think that's it for the body at this moment. And I'll do the tires as another video. Thanks for watching. And then we'll do the electronics. So, you know, I'm going to sweep all this crap back into the parts box. If I change my mind on the body parts, I have everything I need in that box. Well, everything else I need, because I just dropped one. I have no idea where it went. Just to look like it could go together. That doesn't work either. I don't see how this goes together. Okay. Well, let's work on the other side for a minute. Maybe it will come to us when we're working upside down. Well, that's starting to look like it could fit. Oh, yeah, that actually could fit right there. And then there. Okay, yeah, that actually fits. Yes, that works. Really? It calls for these dang ass bolts? So this 116 goes in the back. Okay. Now we gotta get this one together. So we'll just snap that in place. And then it calls for another 118, which is a really long screw. Alright, so that's in. Now we gotta figure out how that mirrors. So anchor that there. That's it. So those holes are a little bit loose there. And then this just pops in here. And then it gets a long one. Hurts my hands. Alright, so there's that. Oof, that sucked. Almost as much as this can suck, but I gotta sweep everything off and turn the page. Okay. Okay. Now we're in for a lot of screwing. Okay, there we go. Oh, I see what's doing. All right. So these are 1/18s, which are 3 by 18 millimeter. Alright, I get to rest my hand. I'm going to finish the second screw and then I'll rest my hand. Okay, so that's good. And then we've got a 16, which is a 3 by 12. Thank you. Okay. Now your 25 millimeter screw goes down in here. Eek. I just hope some of this passes through. Oh, thank goodness. So otherwise, that was going to be a really, really hard screw to put in. So I'm watching these little gaps between the frame members, and I'm just closing it off. That's starting to come together. All right, what else do we got here? So this is a... Oh, we got one at the top. It's a 118, which is a... 3x18. Alright, so that's figuring into feel, and then we need another 118. That's not it. But that is. And it's going to go in through the back. And that's going to take a while to screw in because we've got like half an inch of thread to do. And it makes me wonder if they couldn't have been a little different configuration at this point instead of having a half an inch of thread. So what do we need on the side? A 116. And I just want to anchor this because it's kind of rolling around as I'm trying to screw in the back. As these come together, this frame will get exponentially stronger as these connections are made. Even if some of them screw halfway across the frame. Hang on a second.